Hey guys, it's me, back again with another reaction video on this channel. Today I will be checking out Madtown YOLO, which is their debut song. Yeah, there's only one Madtown song that I know, and that's Oh My God Thanks, OMGT. And I really like that song, to be honest. I just never really got into them more, and obviously they're disbanded now, which is sad, but I think it's also for the better for the members, because of what the company did and everything that happened. I don't know everything, but I know like a few facts. Because the reason why I also reacted to this is, and why it's uploaded today actually, is because a very good friend of mine has her birthday today. So yeah, happy birthday to you if you're watching this. I hope you are, because this is for you, kind of. A small birthday gift, right? Because I know it's one of her favorite groups, or was one of her favorite groups, right? She still listens to them a lot, I think, and really likes them, but obviously they disbanded. But yeah, I thought that I would definitely react at some point to more of them, and now that she has birthday, I kind of thought like, okay, why not? Also kind of fits that earlier today I also uploaded this Sunmi Gotta Go dance performance reaction video, and she also really likes Sunmi, so yeah, today is kind of the birthday day for her. She also has a YouTube channel, so if you clicked on this video, you can see it in the title. I add her YouTube channel, so yeah, just check it out. She does a lot of K-pop videos as well, not as frequently, and she doesn't do like reactions. She does more, I would say, fan videos and opinion videos and games and stuff like that. So just check it out. They're definitely good. I can recommend. And yeah, again, happy birthday! And let's start this reaction video. I think there's subtitles, but let's check it out again. Yeah, they are. That's good. And I have never heard this song. I have no idea what this is about, unless they're literally just talking about YOLO, which is a formally popular term, I would say. You only live once, right? Pretty sure they meant that here as well, because it kind of fits in the time slot. It came out in October 2014. But yeah, let's start Madtown's YOLO. My second ever reaction, or no, not reaction, checking out Madtown. Kind of going back to the roots with their debut, right? Actually, before I start, why I chose this song is just because I kind of wanted one of two things, the most viewed one or the debut, I guess, and this looked the most promising in a sense when I searched them up, so I just chose this one. It's kind of random, but yeah. Okay. Someone is locked up there, or actually, multiple people, right? Because he is the guy out of the. Okay, that was kind of aggressive. I didn't expect that. Like that growl and the dog. That was aggressive. Okay. I really don't like that dog breed. I actually hate it. But okay. Anyways. Oh, I like that set though. Okay, I like that. So far, definitely older K-pop vibes. I mean, it's 2014. A lot of dark colors, a lot of dark clothes, kind of emo scenes, locations like this. And also, I would say that their makeup is pretty heavy. Pretty, like, dark eyeliner and stuff, I think. I'm not quite sure, but I think I saw that. So, yeah, let's start here where I dropped off. I like that move with the hands. Starting off with red. Yeah. Okay, the makeup's not really that heavy. I don't know why I thought that. Ooh. His voice is very unique. And he doesn't look like he has this voice. For some reason, he looks like he has a very deep voice. Okay. YOLO here, there, this way, that way. Okay. Before I go on, and I think another rap part, this kind of seems like a dance song, or like the kind of. Not dance, but the kind of like telling people, okay, let's have fun, let's dance, let's have a party, and let's go, like, not crazy, but let's just run, jump around, have fun, right? That's kind of what I get here. Also with that YOLO concept a little bit, kind of ties into that having a party, going crazy, you don't care about what's happening afterwards, like no consequences and stuff. That's the one thing. The other thing is the choreo is interesting. Like, it's actually, yeah, I don't know, very unique and not many upper, not very lower body movements. It's very upper body fair focused, and I don't remember when I've last seen such a choreo. He's mad. When everyone's in a rush, I take it easy. That's really cool. Kinda they speak a little bit of about youth as well, and about young people finding their way and just doing what they want in a sense. And when everyone's in a rush, I take it easy. That's one big part of that, right? Everyone is like telling young people, or I mean, I consider myself as a young person as well. I'm still like studying, right? So everyone tells us, in a sense, that we should just do that, do this, and go by the rules strictly, no pause in between, just go straight to the top in terms of like jobs and education and stuff. And at least that's what people here in Germany, where I live, do, and it's very pressuring for children, in my opinion, especially if you're like 14 to 16 or something, when you're like kind of at the end of high school. Yeah, it's, I don't know. And I think that attitude here, when everyone's in a rush, I take it easy, is one big part of how a person finds his, like, inner peace and also his own goal, his own dream in his life. And I think that's one of the first steps. So I think that's really, really cool that they appeal to that. No one chooses my life, task that answers you to it. Yeah, that's another part of that, right? Nobody can tell me what I should do. I will do what I want. Kind of like that. Toss that answer sheet away. Maybe also tying into education, like that this person doesn't really want to study anymore, I guess, just wants to work or something. Or he's kind of tired of studying because everyone is always saying study, study, study. Okay, now that I pay more attention though, they definitely use their lower body, of course. I mean, you can't not dance without lower body, right? But they have basic movements with their lower body. They're just like kind of bouncing from left to right, left to right, left to right. So that's basically the only thing they do with their feet, most of the time at least, from what I can tell. And in the upper body, the movements are also not like super crazy or something, like it's very simple in a sense. So, interesting, interesting. I wonder how this would look like as a stage. Because this song has so different levels of energy that I'm a bit confused with the dance, because in a sense, this song has a lot of energy, especially in the rap parts, but also the message. And kind of like the BPM, the beat is pretty fast paced, I would say, from time to time. Not always, but it gets fast paced sometimes, and it kind of feels like there's a lot of energy coming. But then this dance, especially, like, exerts not much energy. It's kind of like slowing the energy down a bit. So I don't know what's going on. It's interesting. I guess it's just a vibe, right? It's very easy to dance. I mean, easy. It's easier to dance for average people. Okay, never mind, by the way. Now they're dance breaking. Wait, what? The way we live, there's no faking. Those who know will know. No being tied down. We just enjoy. Yeah, okay, so you only live once. Okay, I kind of get what they're hinting at now. It's not really only, or maybe, maybe I was a bit wrong. It's probably not so much about choosing your own life path. It's kind of just doing what you want in general, right? That you only live once mentality, kind of just like, yeah, not living by anyone other's dreams or goals or what they say. Just do what you want in general in all your life, like in your free time even, like do what you want. Like if you want to play soccer, play soccer. If you want to skateboard, skateboard. If you want to game, game. Stuff like that. Not if your parents say stop that, you don't care about that. Kind of like that. And also just not giving a fuck about a lot of stuff, right? Okay, so it's much more in general life motto, not as much focused on education as I thought at the beginning. By the way, I really like their like outfits in a sense, because they're super super clean. Like also the hair and the styling is super clean. It almost doesn't fit to the graffiti skateboard emo concept they're doing here. Not really emo, but just kind of skater boy, which also is a little bit emo, but whatever. Kind of that concept, it almost doesn't fit their good styling and hair. Like, it's almost too different, but it still fits in a sense. Okay. He fell down there. Man, okay. They're killing it with the dance breaks, though. Oh, I like that part. That reminded me of Bobby from Icon so much. You know, that random shout and scream. Also, his energy. Okay, yeah, now they're literally just vandalizing. Oh, I like that ending shot a lot. Okay, that was Matt Town's YOLO and Their Debut Song, which I think is a really cool debut song, I think. I say I think a lot, this reaction, I'm sorry for that. But it's a really cool way to opening up to potential new fans, although that's obviously now not important anymore because they disbanded. But at that time, I think it was a really good choice, and just kind of doesn't show too much about your style. It's very, like, it almost sounds bad, but it's very, very generic. Most of the time it would be bad, of course, but I think as a debut song that's not bad, because they really showed that they understand the youth, they understand the people they're making music for, right? Because most people that listen to music in general is the youth and early adulthood. And and yeah, they just did really well. But still, they didn't block themselves from any other concept. They let it open for themselves. So, for the next comeback, I think, which was actually probably Oh My God Thanks. I might be wrong about that, but Oh My God Thanks was 2015, so it could be. They let themselves open for everything. They could do everything after this, because this is so, yeah, normal that they can go everywhere. Anyways, I'm kind of going in a circle here. Yeah, I like this song. It's definitely a bit dated, though. Like, I would not listen to this too much nowadays. It's kind of a relic of the past, in my opinion. The song lyrics are cool and the meaning, but also, yeah, also outdated in a sense, because that word YOLO, or that meaning, at least here in Germany, I don't know how that's for every other country, but I believe it's similar. It's very outdated and almost not cool anymore. I think it's actually not cool anymore. It's almost uncool to say it nowadays, and it's also obviously something you live by a bit. I think everyone kind of lives by you only live once, and you should risk things and stuff. And everyone should live like that a bit, but it's just not in a trend anymore to use that phrase to appeal to that and stuff like that. So This song as a whole doesn't really appeal to me as much as, yeah, I guess newer songs of today would. But it's still very interesting to see how they debuted and how K-pop sounded in 2014. So that's why I checked this out. And I hope, yeah, you liked my reaction. If you did, please leave a like on this video, subscribe to my channel if you haven't yet, and also let me know in the comments down below what I should react to next. You can request anything. Yeah, that's it. Check out my socials as well, which is Twitter for updates and Patreon for exclusive content. And see you in the next video. Peace.